I am well aware that I've been talking about the special extinction crisis a lot recently. I'm basically the Billy Ray Cyrus of comedians. I've got one hit and I'm gonna ride it to the grave. But look at the project. I know it's harder to watch than those English botched plastic surgery shows, but what does every guy with a Holden as their Facebook display say about the project?
Bloody lefty tree hugger shit, too right!
Anyway, here's the project advocating cutting down koala habitat.
This is natural koala habitat, inland from Taree in New South Wales.
Oh, I can eat koala. They don't mind logging. They don't stay in one spot, they're always moving. They don't set up camp and just stay there and that's it.
How is this better than Sky News? At least when you're watching Sky, you don't feel like punching the hosts in the head. They start off interviewing, I think, Chris Franklin, whose primary defence for logging koala habitat when the species is on the verge of extinction is...
There's no actual evidence that the logging diminishes the koalas. What will the Greens and the people in the city think if you ban all cats and dogs? Well, they kill koalas. Cars? Gonna ban cars? All you can do is limit your impact on them.
No, I'll tell you what you do. You think about the highways you build and put nature impasses over them instead of expecting a creature with a smooth brain to learn road safety rules when it's only slightly faster than a sloth. I don't fancy their odds when I almost got run over the other day and I can at least read the word stop.
We're doing the koala a favour. Koalas like young eucalypt trees and fresh leaves. If you've got old trees that are dying, the koalas don't live in them, don't eat them.
Oh, okay. I'm going to go over to this man's house, right smack bang in the middle of dinner, which I can only imagine consists of 4 and 20 pies, Friday night footy, and this specific chair, with one of his own bulldozers. Demolish it with him in it, an explosion of gravy and blood marking the end of his third negatively geared property, as I say, cyclones demolish houses. You going to ban cyclones?
Wood and other products like oils and carbon that come from Australian forests contribute more than $9 billion to our economy. Logging and the forestry industry creates around 50,000 jobs, most of those in regional communities.
Ooh, big number without any context. I'm sick of quiet Australia falling for that same old trick.
$9 billion-y dudes! Imagine the upgrades you can make on a Ford Falcon with that!
$9 billion is nothing to the wider economy. We could probably generate more economic activity just by putting the host of this segment on one of those circus dunk boxes and charge 10 bucks a ball. When he falls in the water, we can wash out some of the product in his hair. I'd personally get us halfway to that goal. Logging in New South Wales, keep in mind these figures are 4 years old now, lost $79 million. So we can only assume it's losing even more now, seeing as the industry is set to decline a further 14% over the next decade. This in contrast to the fact that if you kept those very trees in the ground, they could have generated $40 million. Think about how insane that is. The Liberals are bringing 1,000 species to the brink of extinction so they can lose money. Yet this man, who's one of the biggest Twitter blue check dickheads there are, always whining about lame SJW shit, yet as soon as there's anything his followers are too dumb to get offended by, which let's be honest, is basically anything of real value.
Yeah, no, I'll defend a dying logging industry whose sole purpose appears to be mulching up native animals for 5 minutes on the project. Daddy wants a Walkley Award.
He then goes on to interview Steve Dobbins and refers to him as, quote,
he's also a forest scientist.
Saying Steve Dobbins is a forest scientist is like saying a guy in the 50s with a medical degree from the University of Winfield who's paid by cigarette companies is a doctor. He's just fucking Tasmanian Dr. Nick. A bigwig at a private forestry consultancy firm and a member of the Institute of Foresters of Australia, a lobby group that demands academics pull research that dares suggest that forestry, who'd have guessed, might be having adverse impacts on ecosystems. Their defence essentially being, no, you're not seeing the big picture here. I'm a nice guy.
There's pretty steep fines if you're caught breaking the rules.
Oh, really? Because this is Paula Flack. She's the president of the Nambucca Valley Conservation Association. Here's what she says about loggers following their restrictions and guidelines.
They did still log other areas in the compartment that had koala feed trees and yellow-belly glider feed trees. And when we came back in after the logging, we found breaches of their logging rules where they had actually taken yellow-belly glider feed trees that they shouldn't have. And we're still waiting for the government to respond to our breach report.
This is Kylas Wild, a wildlife rescuer who rescued 107 koalas during the bushfires, and I'm still pretty certain is a big fan of dune rats.
In front of me is the Eucalyptus punctata, commonly known as a grey gum. You can see the damage that's been done as part of the logging. And you can see here where the koala's been using it.
This is Chris Gambian, head of the Nature Conservation Council of New South Wales, stating that the New South Wales Forestry Corporation has been breaking environmental laws for years, but has only rarely been brought to account. So what the project has done is essentially asked the Coco Pops monkey what he thinks about crunchy chocolate milkshakes, and then cut to a reporter saying, interesting. In fact, worse than that, asking two loggers and a logging lobbyist if they think that what they're doing is moral, and then airing their objectively incorrect justifications without right of reply. I mean, who'd have thought Rove doesn't know how to run a news program? I don't expect much from the project other than Peter Hellyer informing me of the latest viral video 3 months too late. But I certainly don't expect them to let loggers off the hook, who do kill koalas, that's just fact. Here's one they killed the other day, saying there's no evidence to suggest the koala mulcher 5000 mulches koalas. The more you know. This is how much of a friend to koalas the forestry industry is. The Great Koala National Park in northern New South Wales was a community initiative started by scientists and concerned citizens. It would have been 315,000 hectares of prime koala habitat that would have been permanently protected. Nature-based tourism is worth $20 billion a year in New South Wales alone, to put in perspective the measly $9 billion in forestry that wannabe Wiley is talking about. Obviously, Labor in the last election said, yep, we'll commit to that. Wouldn't you guess? The Liberals said no. Why? Because f***ing Forestry New South Wales wanted to continue turning some of the last remaining koala habitat into wood chip illegally, at a loss, and the Libs legitimately looked at that proposal and wondered where the downside was. All the while, the so-called left-wing tree-hugger press in this country sits there and defends these yahoos by letting them air their baseless views. I don't know how many more times I can say this, but the project isn't my favourite show. Like this video if you think Angry Beavers, for instance, might be a little bit better than the project. And tell you who I'm a big fan of though, Lonely Kids Club. Check them out at lonelykidsclub.com, who, to commemorate us fracturing the New South Wales Coalition, made this sweet new Koala Killer t-shirt. And because Warwick is such a legend, every cent in profit that we make will be going to the Animal Rescue Cooperative. Now, I'm not making any money out of this, but while you're there, go buy some Lonely Kids Club merch. All of it's awesome, and you'll get another shirt out of it, so I don't know why you're complaining. I don't want to hear any more of you whining. Press the like button and subscribe. I'm sick of you being very nice to me and doing what I say.
Please share and comment below.
Comment.